In Boris Effects' Continuum 2024, we recently introduced BCC plus UpRes ML, but for After Effects only. Now this incredible AI-driven effect is available in all of our hosts, including Premiere Pro, Avid Media Composer, DaVinci Resolve, and Final Cut Pro, to name a few. I'm going to be showing you how to work with this inside of Premiere Pro, but rest assured, you can carry this workflow over into any host that you are currently using. Let's dive right into my timeline and get a sense for this workflow. Okay, so I'm here inside of my Premiere Pro timeline, and I'd like to scale up this shot that we have here. Now, inside of Premiere Pro, you do have the option with the clip selected to go to your effect controls, which you can do by pressing Shift 5 with the clip selected. And I'm going to scale this up to 200%. Problem is that this actual scaler isn't driven by machine learning. So what we end up with, if we take a full screen look at this, control tilde, in order to do that, is we can see that there's some noise in the shot, not to mention there is a bit of blurriness in some of the details, especially here in her hat and in her clothing. I'm going to escape out of the full screen playback and then just press Command Z to undo the changes that I just made to the clip. Instead, we're going to work with BCC plus UpRes ML. So I'm going to press Shift 7 in order to go to Effects Panel, and we can just do a search for UpRes, R-E-S, and we'll find that in the Image Restoration category of BCC. Once I select this effect and apply it to a clip, it's going to start to process this. Now, if you've just installed Continuum, this effect is going to take a while to process the first time. But after it's done initializing, you'll get your result, and it's going to be a lot quicker on each subsequent time that you use it. Here's my clip. It's already scaled up, and I'm going to go to Effect Controls because I do want to make a change to the positioning here. So I'll go to the center value and set that to 200 instead. And keep in mind that because this involves a lot of processing power, it may take a while to update here on your screen. But now, if we take a look, here is that end result. And just pay attention to the detail here around this lady's hat, not to mention some of the sharpening in her face. I'll just compare that to the native upscale. You may be able to see some differences and a bit more softness in this specific shot compared to the machine learning shot. Now, it's good practice that once you've applied BCC plus UpRes ML and have dialed in the properties to taste, then to render and replace it in your timeline in order to gain real-time playback. I'm going to right-click here on the clip here in my timeline and choose Render and Replace. I will choose a QuickTime format in the Apple ProRes 422 codec. And in this case, this is an HD format, so it's going to be 25 frames per second. And I want to store it here next to the original media, but I can do that wherever I'd like. In addition to this, I'm also going to include video effects. This means that I'll be able to see on the rendered clip the effects that I used. This could also be handy in collaborative workflows if you ever sent this over to someone else, so that they can make sure that they have these effects installed on their system. Let's press OK. And it's going to analyze the project and in the background get to work rendering and replacing out the existing footage with the effect. Okay, the effect has been successfully rendered and replaced. I can tell by the yellow line, not to mention effect controls, the BCC plus UpRes ML effect has now been grayed out. So let's just give this a playback. I'm just going to go control tilde, go to the beginning of my timeline, and I can preview the end result. I can see definitely a lot of sharpening detail, but I'm not so satisfied what has occurred in this person's skin tones. So I'm going to press escape, go back to the original clip by simply right-clicking and going restore unrendered. This is the magic of render and replace with BCC plus UpRes ML. I can always go back to the original clip, make changes, and render out another one. Here with this clip selected, I'm actually going to go to the sharpening amount and lower that a bit, also decrease the sharpening radius a bit. And I can always render this out again because I'm pleased with this result. Now let's take a look at another use of BCC plus UpRes ML. So I'm going to head over to my clips bin, and this is the shot that I would like to UpRes. So I'm going to drag it into a new sequence. Just so that we're all on the same page, I'm going to right-click that clip inside the project panel and just show you that it is an HD clip with a frame rate of 25. What I'm going to do with my sequence is go to the sequence settings and first of all, double that in size. So I'll type in asterisk 2 next to 1920, as well as do the same thing for the horizontal dimension. So now I have a UHD sequence, which I'll accept pressing OK, followed by OK, and also matching the frame rate as well as the color space of this clip. I'll head over to my effects panel and drop BCC plus UpRes on this shot. And since I've already used this effect once, it's going to be a lot quicker to initialize on this next attempt and see the end result. In order to preview this a bit faster, I'm actually going to go to the program monitor and then just bring down the quality. Just allow me to hop to another frame to make sure that I'm happy with the result that I'm seeing. Now, if I was just going to use this clip as is, I would render and replace like we did in the last example. But since I want to be able to bring this into other projects and maybe even After Effects, I'm going to export this out. I'll press Control M or Command N on my Mac in order to go to the Media Export section. And here I'll send out an Apple ProRes 422 Ultra HD file that I can see here in the output settings and then choose Export. Now, if you have Adobe Media Encoder installed on your system, you could use that for export while continuing to work inside of Premiere Pro. Okay, here's the clip I just exported and I loaded it into QuickTime where we can just show the movie inspector. It's matching the full UHD resolution, not to mention the encoded frame rate. If I play that back, this quality looks just great for the 4K clip that I now have. Let's take a look at one final example that I've already prepared inside of Premiere Pro. Okay, this was the original plate shot. And what I really wanted to do was zoom in on it a couple times. So I added UpRes one time to this clip and had a 2x scale. And this was the result that you saw here. And then I added a 3x upscale so we could get really close. And this is the result we see here with some of the sharpening detail. I then added BCC plus crash zoom just to act as a nice dissolve between these clips as we continue to transition and zoom out further and further, and ended up with a nice establishing medium and close shot all put together in a nice sequence of clips. So there's the first, the second, and the third clip and the results of those. And there you have it, working with BCC plus UpRes ML inside of Continuum 2024. And now available in all hosts. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, as well as subscribe to more content just like this on Boris Effects' YouTube. See you next time.